welcome back to my YouTube channel, and in today's video, as you guys can tell by the thumbnail, today's video is going to be testing out a brand, a very affordable brand, and that is Body Collection. Body Collection you can actually get in Wilko, so if you have a near Wilko then go to it. But the most expensive thing I bought today was £4. I will tell you how much everything is as it goes along. So we're going to be testing out Body Collection. I've wanted to test out this brand since I watched Steph Toms like use them all the time and fall in love with their foundation. So if you don't know about this little guy and how it's ended up everywhere, all over everyone's you page and everything, then that's where that's from. But I basically have a full face. I think the only thing I don't have is a cream bronzer, I think that's it, and an eyeshadow palette, that is it. Everything else I have. Oh, and I don't have a mascara because they didn't have any, but that's the only thing I don't have. So we're going to be doing a full face of Body Collection. If you want to keep on watching, and yeah, watch this video and see what I think of this brand. A lot of these things are like £2, £3, literally £1.50, that everything was so affordable. So yeah, let's get into today's video. I've already soaked browed up my brows. When I carve out my brows, I'm going to use my normal concealer because the concealer that I have here from them is very, very liquidy. If I put this on my eyebrows, they're gonna move. Like, water will make them move, so I have to use my other concealer, but that's literally the only thing that I'm going to use. But let's get into it and start using the products. And yeah, if you are not already subscribed, please do make sure you are. Why not join the family and leave a like, comment down below. Let's get into today's video. So first I'm going in with the Body Collection eyebrow definer pencil in just light brown, and that is, yep, this was £1.50, and it is one of those pencils that is retractable. I want to see how much product you get. Get basically a standard amount of product. That's literally how much you get in a lot of pencils, and for £1.50 you can't complain. But let's swatch it, see what it's like. It's definitely on that drier side, but it seems like a pretty good colour. So yeah, let's start to fill in the brows and hope that they can do something to them, because they're looking questionable. Okay? Filling in slightly. Oh, it's doing it. You just have to warm it up a bit. Honestly, look at that brow compared to that brow. Definitely filled it in. It's actually a really nice colour. £1.50, guys. It's cheaper than the Primark one. The Primark one was £2. This one's £1.50, and that is a beautiful shade. You know what? I really like that. For £1.50, you can't fault that. It's a little bit on that dry formula, so you have to press a little bit harder, but genuinely, that is really good for £1.50. Amazing. I'm gonna quickly go off camera, carve out my brows, and then we'll be back to do the rest of my skin. Okay, back with the brows are carved out. Honestly, really love that brow pencil. Think it's so sick. It's just on that drier formula, so just press a little bit harder. But genuinely, the pigmentation you get is unreal. So I really like that for £1.50. You'll be seeing me use this multiple times. Okay, next we're going in with a primer. So the primer we have today, I think this was £3. This primer was £3. Not bad at all. It's the Illuminating Primer Lightweight Skin, Rich Skin Feel, suitable for all skin tones. It just looks like this. Just a flat type of packaging. Kind of reminds me of the Charlotte Tilbury packaging of their kind of primer. But I did actually swatch this in the shop, and it looked so pretty. It has this like slight sheen to it, and I love primers that are like that at the moment. Give my skin a little bit of help to it, because I'm due on and a few friends came about to play. So let's pop this on and see how it feels. You can tell even by squidging it. Do you see the reflect? It has these like tiny little bit of sheen to it. Am I gonna look like Tin Man by the end of this? Not sure. Okay, just had to reply to someone on Facebook, because I've just brought a TV stand and a coffee table for £50. I was about to spend £300 for a TV stand and a coffee table, then saw on Facebook Marketplace that they were selling one, both of them for £50. I was like, are you serious? Hold on a second. Can you see that on my skin? There's no like shimmer particles at all. It's just pure glow. I want some more. Hold up a second. Hold up. £3. This is kind of giving me exactly what I want. Like, look at that. Oh my god. Oh my. It has this slight like, do you know the smell of jelly beans? It kind of smells like that, but oh my god. I love how the way that's made my skin look. Okay, some of my forehead. This is £3. I might have to grab another one of these, because like, look. You have it on, it's got that slight shine to it. I want to put some more on my cheek. Genuinely looks beautiful. Obsessed. If you like that glow to your skin, you would love this. It has kind of smoothed out areas as well. It's definitely gone that tacky feel look, which is good. It means my foundation's gonna sit down. I actually feel like that's not gonna sit in my fine lines either. I really like that. Okay, next is the thing that I've seen everywhere. I'm gonna see how this lays on top of this primer, and then I might tell you that you need to go get this. That was, it looks so beautiful. Okay, it's now open. I've got some sticky residue on it, but do you know what? It's fine. I actually got the Body Collection Illuminated Liquid Foundation Light to Medium Buildable Coverage, 30 mils. This has just been everywhere. This is in the shade Light Beige. There wasn't many shades. I think there was like 8 shades in the store I went to, but to be honest, this looks like it wouldn't be too bad for me. It might match me, might not. When does my foundation ever match? Oh my god, there's more sticky stuff. Okay, I just kind of snipped off the bit that was sticky attaching this, because otherwise it takes off the back and then I wouldn't know what shade this is. Genuinely, my skin looks so good. Why is my nose kind of looks like Tin Man though? Anyway, this foundation, oh, mine's kind of exploded a little bit. To be honest, I have had mine bouncing about in a bag for the past like few months because I bought this like 2 months ago. This whole haul, I just not have had time to sit down and play with this makeup. So now we're ready. It comes with a pump. Yes, please. This was actually £4. This was the most expensive thing, but genuinely foundation should be because you get a lot for your money. I know Steph Toms actually rants and raves about this foundation, so I kind of want to love this because otherwise I'll be so upset. So upset. Okay, going in with my Neil Brittany sponge, just stained, but here we are. And this is the shade. It actually looks like a pretty good shade. Slightly yellow, but not bad at all. Hold up a second. Recently, I've been loving this like light to medium coverage foundations because I can always just kind of spot conceal. It's making my skin look so much better and not cakey. Full coverage foundation can make you look a little bit on that drier texture, even if you do get an illuminating one. But I've been loving foundations like this. With that primer underneath, that is beautiful. This foundation is reminding me of my L'Oreal True Match foundation. So if you like that foundation, and I swear that's like £8, £8, £9. This is £4. You get the exact same merge. I'm pretty sure this is pretty much the same shade. This might be a dupe for that because it's looking good on the skin. The only thing I'm scared about today is the concealer. Oh, am I terrified for that one. I really like that. Shade matches me pretty well. Maybe got the tiniest bit too dark, but genuinely most foundations are. This is in the shade Light Beige. So if you're my shade, then yeah. But look at that glow. It has this like slight smell. It's not like the worst smell, just kind of like a smell that you would tell it's there, but not really like, oh my god, it stinks. Just has a slight fragrance. I want this not to sit on my fine lines. Would be great. Okay, going around the brows. I like this foundation. You know what? This is going straight into my kit. For those days that I want to do like a drugstore, full on, not even drugstore, but like really cheap makeup video, this will be involved because that is a beautiful foundation. Oh, am I obsessed? Oh yeah, I really like that. That is absolutely stunning and I really, really enjoyed that. It's literally sitting on my skin very, very similar to the L'Oreal True Match foundation. It's very similar to, and in fact, the LA Girl foundation, this foundation is kind of the same type of feel. So now I'm happy that I have another one that's like this because I've been obsessed, because it's also like this one, the Shein one. These four foundations are very similar to each other, but also very, very good. I love that. It is so lightweight on the skin. You can't barely feel it. Obviously you can feel that there's a slight wetness to the skin, but it's definitely sat down really nicely, and that primer through it. This combo sits beautifully and it's not breaking up in any of my areas either. Yes. Okay, next is the concealer. This was £1.50 and that is the reason why I'm scared. Concealer I pay a little bit more for because I need that coverage, I need that formula to be on point, because when I like my low coverage foundation, I want a full coverage concealer. So this is the Body Collection concealer, that's all it says, and it's in the shade Fair. It is very liquidy, so we're gonna see how this feels. It has like a kind of lip gloss applicator, not the best. It smells like very cheap makeup, but it also feels very liquidy, like it feels like water. You can kind of see by the sheen of it that is one of those just very liquidy concealers. I am hoping this is a good concealer because obviously I love to test out new products and stuff, but if something's good, then I really like that. I'd rather it be good than bad, because then obviously I'm just kind of wasted money on something I don't like. The applicator is a little bit awkward. Like, you can definitely tell on my nose. Do you see that sheerness? This is definitely a very light coverage concealer, so I'm gonna have to leave it sit for a minute. I've dipped in like 8 times as well. If I let it sit, it'll kind of stick to my skin a bit. You see how it's like kind of see-through? Okay, now I'm gonna blend out my face makeup whilst my under eyes sit, because if you just saw, it's slightly taking away the foundation that's underneath on the spots that I've left put it on. I don't like this. I don't like it at all. Come here. I'm gonna show you. On the end of my nose, it's like flaking off. Like it's made this like congealed. No. You know what? Just blend it in, Becca. Just blend it in. On my nose, it does not look nice. It's stuck to a patch here and removed. Do you see that circle there where I stuck it? Removed the foundation straight away. So let's see what it does underneath the eyes. Okay, this might be a product you don't go and buy. Hold up a minute. What? Under my eyes, it looks beautiful. It looks silky, airbrushed, kind of covered a little bit. It's like a light coverage concealer. It looks beautiful. On my nose is a whole other story. Like, it is breaking up on my nose. Like, it's just flaking. So I'm gonna put a bit more foundation on my nose and just kind of leave my nose, but under my eyes, it seems fine. Yeah, it just has done something to my nose that I don't like, but yet underneath my eyes seems perfectly fine. Under my eyes, fine. Forehead, chin is kind of okay. Yeah, the chin's fine now, but it's just my nose. It does not lie. You know what, I kind of rate that like a 6 out of 10. For the price, you cannot complain. It doesn't like my nose, so maybe there was a little bit too much primer on my nose that it didn't like, or it doesn't like the primer that is on my nose, because everywhere else I've put it, there's been primer, but there's a good old like barricade of foundation, and under my eyes, there is no primer. So maybe this concealer doesn't agree with the primer, but the primer is beautiful and it works well with the foundation. I'm pretty sure the primer would work really well with one of my other concealers and stuff like that, which is fine. I think it's just this concealer. You know what? I think it might just be my nose is really dry and it's clinging to that, because it's only on the end of my nose. On the top of my nose is fine. So it might be just clinging to the dryness. So if you are type of dry type of gal, don't get this. But if you don't suffer with dry skin, then £1.50 for this is not bad at all, because it actually does look really good under the eyes. I didn't think I'd like a £1.50 foundation concealer. Yeah, I think it's just, it's literally only on the tip of my nose is where I usually get dry, because that's where I have all like my blackheads, and I usually put strips and stuff like that, and it dries out the end of my nose really quickly and stuff like that. Look at my skin. Like, it looks really good. Okay, stunning. I actually really like that. Just be careful with what type of skin you have. Skin type can really affect some products, and that is one product that you do have to have a specific type of skin type for that to work, which is why it didn't do that same thing all over my other face. It's just on my nose is where I usually get dry from, where that skin kind of flakes off and stuff like that. That's what it's clinging to. So it's not bad concealer at all. It's actually a really nice concealer. For £1.50, you cannot complain, but just make sure you have the right skin type for it. For £1.50, that's good. Next, we have this. I picked this up and I was like, I love cream, and there was one of these left, okay? And I was like, I need something green because I don't have any cream bronzer, okay? And I need some. So this was how much? This was £2.50, not bad. This whole face came up to £25, dead on, which is amazing. But this is their blush stick, illuminating blush stick. And this is in the shade Make Me Blush. So let's try this out. I want to draw it on my skin, but then I'm also really scared. Anyway, let's see how creamy it is on my hand. That's very creamy. So I think drawing on my skin will be fine. Ooh, okay. Definitely has that illumination to it, which I really like. It's gliding on the skin really nicely. £2.50, not bad. Let's pop a bit on the nose. I'm liking this color. It's like a pinky mauve type of shade. Okay, putting it back. But it comes in this packaging. Absolutely love the packaging. But it has like this definite glow to it. Like it's a very glowy type of a blusher. Now going in my blusher brush. Oh, that adds even more glow to the skin. Very pretty shade. Look at that. I love blushes, so I put loads on. You don't have to put this much on, but I really like how that looks. I actually really like how that looks. I'm using blush to contour today. Yeah, everything else is sitting nicely on the top of my nose. It's just on the bottom. Yeah, it's definitely just the dryness on the end of my nose. Did my skincare last night. Maybe I just didn't like my tea tree oil because I had to put that on because of my breakout. But that made my skin so pretty. But yeah, I actually really like that. For £2.50, you cannot complain. How good is that? If you're the type of girl that doesn't like wearing highlighter but loves blush, this is everything. Talking about highlighter, the only highlighter they had was a liquid highlighter, and this is the only shade they had as well. So either this or a very pink one. I was like, I'm not a pink type of girl. So this is the Body Collection Liquid Illuminator, and this is in the shade Bronze. You get 14 mils of product. I think this was Okay, this was £3, not bad at all. So it comes with this little pipette, but I'm pretty sure the pipette doesn't work. I did open it to kind of swatch it. So wait, does the pipette work? Yeah, no, the pipette does not work at all. But to be honest, you can kind of just whack it out, give it a wiggle, whack it out. Do I just straight up throw it on the skin? Yeah. Okay, do you know what? I'm gonna do one bit at a time before I go crazy. Going in with the butt of my beauty blender. Yeah. See how it's kind of stuck a little bit? That's why you don't do the whole of your face at the same time. Yeah, it's stuck originally where I put it, so definitely don't go straight onto your face with that. Pretty, but let me put it on my beauty blender. Yeah, just kind of made a little patch on my beauty blender. Oh, that was a lot. That is a lot. Oh, yeah. Straight up on the beauty blender, so much better. Letting it sit, it will stick to the skin, and that's what you're gonna end up suffering with. But look at that. Yeah, we're looking very glowy today, but honestly, kind of love. Will highlighter sort out the situation on my nose? Hey, let's find out. If something's gonna stick to my nose, it's definitely gonna be this highlighter. And I was right. We are looking so glowy, we need some powder up in here. But I really like that. I definitely prefer just putting it on the beauty blender. I brought it down a little bit low here, but honestly, not bad at all. But that shade is really nice, and for £3. Looks stunning. Absolutely stunning. Next, we have their pressed powder. So this is their body collection pressed powder, matte one. And this is in the shade light. I think this is the lighter shade, not sure. Maybe there's a fair shade, but this was the lighter shade that was there when I went there. So, blend out the under creases. Yeah, this concealer doesn't crease much, only creases a little bit. Okay, now we get a brush. Grab this on the brush. This is my Beauty Bay brush, and see what this does. This is gonna add the coverage that concealer kind of didn't give a lot of coverage. It just kind of covered the dark circles. It didn't do a lot more than that. Let's set my under eyes down. I wish this had a mirror. Seems like a really good shade for me. You know what, that's so smooth. I need to show you up close about this. Look, okay, let it concentrate. Look how smooth my under eye is. Look, there's like no creasing form. It created this beautiful kind of blur to the under eye. Like, look, you can definitely see how that has worked. If you hear my boyfriend playing with the dog, he's literally just come down to look after him for a bit whilst I finish off filming, because I think he's just woken up. So let's set this under eye. I quite like this powder. Oh, I forgot to tell you how much it was. Whoopsies. Let's make sure that under eye is set though, because my under eye is looking really good. Okay, this powder was £2 and it's so good. Okay, now let's set other parts of my face. You can kind of use this to lighten up areas as well, where that concealer just didn't do the lightening. And if your foundation's a little bit too dark, this is a little bit lighter. We're gonna set my forehead. The foundation has not sat in my fine lines, which is so good. Like, there's a slight little line, but it's not sitting in it. It's just where it is. I don't have a set in spray because they didn't actually do one, I don't think. They didn't have one there when I was looking. But I'm sorry. That powder is so good. I actually think for £2 is really good. Like, just look how smooth my under eye is looking. Like, I can't lie to you here. Like, this is the smoothest my under eyes have looked in like days. I think it's the no sleep, to be honest. It's fine. But that is looking so good. And it's kind of died down a bit where the highlighter is, to the point where I want it. Yeah, I really like that. I'm happy about that. Next, we have their medium dark bronzer. I didn't realize this was medium dark. This was the only shade they had. So yeah, this does look dark, so I'm gonna have to go in with a light hand, because if this is pigmented, let's get some real pigment. Oh, we can have a situation going on here. It's so dark. This happened with my Primark bronzer as well. There was like no other shades, so I kind of had to pick up a darker shade. Barely put any on, and it looks sculpted already. Okay, I've literally put the tiniest bit on and kind of tapped it on. Then we can blend it into the skin. You know what? Just tap lightly. I think they do have other shades. Just when I was there, this was the only shade. I was like, in the store, to be honest, it looked a lot lighter. So yeah, to be honest, not a bad color. Not a bad color at all. It's slightly contour. Just kind of rub the bronzer down the edge of my nose. That's how contouring goes nowadays. Now on the forehead, it's the real test. Got no cream bronzer on, so it's so strange putting bronzer on without any like already defined part there. You know what, I'm not even tapping off the excess right now, and I'm just kind of going in. Like, I've gone in. And it's a really good colour. I think it just sticks a little bit more here because it's obviously wet. But when you've got a powdered base, this isn't a bad colour at all. Ooh, I think this was £2 as well. Yeah, I think the powder, the blush and the bronzer was £2. The only thing I'm a little bit like, the same size as the powder and the bronzer, but then the blush is this tiny and I'm like, I'm paying the same price, give me the same amount. Okay, I actually really like that bronzer. It actually went on really well, £2. It's actually the Primark one was £1, this was £2, so it's a little bit more on the expensive side for the cheap makeup, but if you're a gal on the go and need a bronzer that's gonna go on smoothly, look how good it's gone on. The only thing I'm a bit like, was the concealer, just a little bit, just because it was clinging onto my nose, but that's, and yes, honestly, I think it's a me problem. The next thing, I've got the blush in the shade Pink. It's just their Body Collection blush. It looks like this. It's such a pretty colour. I am going to use the same brush I used as bronzer because I don't have another brush like it and I need another one. This is the Anil Brittany brushes. They're so good. They're a small Instagram brand. So beautiful. But let's go into this. Is this matte? I thought this was sheeny for some odd reason. Oh, that's a beautiful shade. Bear in mind my cheeks aren't set and this shade is going on so pretty. That's so stunning. I'm kind of throwing it over the highlighter as well, so it all kind of melts together. That looks so pretty. Okay, Body Collection Mind of My Heart. Body Collection, thing is, I watched Steph's video and I was like, it can't be that good. Why does my hair look like a pineapple? Anyway, I was like, it cannot be that good. We're gonna test it out. It's freaking good. I'm gonna drink my Monster. Purely shocked. Next thing is, I need to quickly blend my creases on my eyelid and set them with the powder. Forgot I needed to do that. We could go in with a bit of bronzer, which I will do. Yeah, let's kind of do like a little eye look using the powders. So going in with the bronzer first, just with this brush from Poundland. I have like three of these, they're actually really good. Okay, getting that and just plopping it on the edge. You see how good this concealer is as a base to my eyeshadow. You know what, sometimes just use what you've got as eyeshadow, because at the end of the day, powder is powder. You're on the go for the day and you don't want to carry around an eyeshadow palette. Using what you've got is genuinely the next best thing. Pretty, adding a little bit more. And also using your bronzer means that your eyes kind of match your face and it's so pretty when you do that. I'm just kind of winging it out a little bit. Absolutely. That looks stunning. Yeah, now let me do this quickly. This bronzer's got some real pigment to it though, look. You can definitely use this in eyeshadow. Look how pigmented that is on my eyes, and that is a bronzer. It looks bloody stunning. I'm about to use the powder as like an inner corner brightener. So I'm gonna get this powder, a fluffy-ish flat kind of brush, grab a bit. This is the Shein brush, it's not very good. I'm just kind of using it because I've no other brushes. You know what, it's not very good now either, so. What do you want? What do you want? Are you crying? I know, daddy's doing your food. Okay, just getting a packer brush and this powder and just kind of packing it here just to kind of brighten it up a bit in the inner corner. Want to use the liquid eyeshadow on the same, a liquid highlighter on the same brush, just kind of use it as a inner corner brow bone type moment. Use what you get. I'm stamping a little bit on that brow bone there. I would put it on the lid. You can do if you want, but actually, on the lid it goes, because it's very pigmented, that it's kind of just going to act like a liquid eyeshadow. Oh, that looks so pretty. I really like this liquid shadow. Not liquid shadow, liquid highlighter, because it's got so much pigmentation to it that you can literally use it for anything. Okay, that looks stunning. Absolutely beautiful. See, if I had like another highlighter, like a powder highlighter, I would go in and just pop that on top to make sure that it's fully set with this. So use that, that's what I'm gonna do. But I'm not gonna use one from, so I'm just gonna use my Kiko one. Just grab a bit to set the eyelid. So that way we're gonna know what crease is, because it's obviously a cream and it hasn't been set down. Now just use your brow pencil to create a liner and you are on the go. I don't know, I just wanted to show you how you can use your everyday products to create makeup looks in the end of the day. Let's hope that this doesn't. You know, I don't think it's dark enough. If you're darker browed, then yeah, use that. But if you're light browed like me, then I don't think it's gonna quite work because your brow pencil is pretty light. That's that. I'm gonna quickly pop a mascara on, just my Maybelline Sky High, and then I'll be back to do my lips. Okay, so I just went and put my mascara on. It literally is like a last ever mascara. And I actually put some setting spray on because I realised I was looking really powdery and then I realised I had no setting spray on. So I just used my XX Revolution one just because I'm using it up. But I just had a conversation with my boyfriend as well. Ignore this patch. I've been bitten and it's like affecting me in some way. The concealer is very low coverage. If you are a type of girl that loves a low coverage concealer, you will like this concealer. If you are a type of girl that doesn't have dry skin, you will like this concealer. But if you are a full coverage type of girl that likes full coverage on the eyes, you won't like it. And if you're dry skinned, you won't like it. So you really just have to be very specific about your concealers. And that is basically the only thing that I'm a bit like unsure about. But everything else looks so pretty. And yeah, let's get into doing the lips. The lips, there's a little hiccup here. And when I was in the shop, I'm pretty sure this lipstick was red. But no, I picked up a red lip liner and a pink lipstick. I'm gonna try them out together. Whether they last on my lips that color for when I film my next video is another question. But for this video, I am gonna do it. And if you guys enjoyed that I did a little like eye look using my bronzer and cream highlighter and stuff like that, then comment down below, because genuinely, I think it has worked so well. Kind of loving the glowy look at the moment. Obsessed. But the lip liner was, £1.50 and the lipstick is £2. So this is just the shade red, just red. And this is the shade pink pop. Pretty sure that was in the wrong aisle. But, and I'm just like, eh, it's fine. But this is the lip liner. You know, it's kind of hinting a bit pink. I think I'll be all right, you know. If you look at it, it's hinting a tiny bit pink. So I think they might go well together. Yeah, it's definitely hinting a bit more pink than red. So let's pop this on. It's on that harder formula. But I'm pretty sure this would be good for getting a sharp line. Yeah, this isn't red, this is pink. You know what's a really nice pink? I don't think I actually have pink lipstick. This lip liner is on the harder side, but it's definitely pigmented and you can just kind of deal with it. But yeah, this is a very pretty pink. If you love pink lips, then this would be really nice. It is one of those lipsticks that I feel that would last all day. Do you know when they're so creamy that like, they wouldn't last all day? This, I feel like, isn't gonna budge. It's that kind of dry. Yeah, I don't think it's gonna go anywhere. Hello, Leo. Is it mummy? I came to say hello. The thing is, I don't mind lip liners being on that drier side. I feel like they're just a lot better at long lasting. If they were dry and not pigmented, then there would be a problem. But they're dry and pigmented, this is something that would just last all goddamn day. And I actually really like that. The color is definitely not red. This is more of a corally pink. So this is the shade. Yeah, I kind of like the look of it. Okay, let's swatch it next to this one. Ooh, it's like a baby pink. Let's see what this looks like. This is definitely an ombre lip type of day. My lips are very dry, so. Straight up, don't like this. It's a nice color. Going with the lipstick nicely, but it has picked up on every bit of dryness on my lip. And I'm gonna show you exactly. So if you look at my lips, on the inner part here, I have always suffered with dry lips. Even if I sit here moisturizing 24/7, they are just gonna be dry. And it has picked up on that dryness. So if you don't have dry lips, this would be fine, but I suffer with dry lips all the time. It's got, it's like medium coverage pigment. It's not like a full coverage lipstick at all. It's a pretty color though. Like, it's definitely one of those lipsticks from far away, look perfectly fine, but up close, that's where the problems become a problem. So yeah, not a fave on that, but the lip liner I prefer. So if you do have a lipstick that would match that lip liner, like this kind of vibe, it would look sick. With like this bronzy eye, it looks beautiful, but that lipstick wasn't it. That's, what a bad way to end a video. Okay, so this is my full face using Body Collection makeup. And if you enjoyed me testing out these lower cost makeup, the makeup that is on the cheap, like the makeup that you'd look at and think, okay, is that even good? Or is that literally just to earn a little bit of coin from some people that probably don't know what they're talking about when it comes to makeup? I think Body Collection have kind of smashed it with a lot of these products. There's only two products that I was iffy on, the lipstick and the concealer. Other than that, everything else I have highly enjoyed. And look at the glow my skin is producing right now. I'm obsessed. Yeah. So if you want me to test out any more low cost brands or anything, that leave them down below and I'll see if I can get hold of them. Lower brands is a lot easier for me to do. Not only does it help the natural everyday person doesn't have £35 spent on a powder. Do you get what I mean? Not every day every people have like hundreds of pounds to spend on makeup. I don't, most people don't, so I don't want to turn my channel into something that only, let's say, 5% people can afford. So yeah, there will be high-end products within my videos, but I always try and give you discount codes and stuff like that, trying to save money. But when it comes to makeup like this, this is where I thrive. It's testing cheap makeup and seeing if it's actually really good and if you can get some good makeup for your price. Because right now, my skin is looking so good. I think just switch up the concealer and use my ColourPop Pretty Fresh and I'd have a flawless base. I think it looks stunning. I'd have a little bit more coverage on the under eyes, but genuinely with that powder and everything, looks stunning. Absolutely amazing. But yeah, if you guys enjoyed today's video, please do leave a like, comment down below. Subscribe if you are not already, because I know over 50% of you aren't subscribed. So if you please can subscribe, it really does help me out. If you know people that would love my content, please do share my videos and stuff like that, as if you guys enjoy my videos, why not share it to other people? Why not create a big old family over here? But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching today's video. Hopefully you enjoyed and hopefully you picked up some products that you would actually quite like. Head yourself over to Wilko. They have some good makeup and I will be putting some of this makeup in my kit. Like this foundation, this primer, this liquid highlighter is beautiful. The brow pencil was okay, it was pretty good. These products are so good. I might even put the powder in my kit, a £2 powder. I genuinely think these products are so good. And that liquid blush, it's so glowy, but I absolutely love it for those days that I just wanna glow. These are the products that I definitely think go and get your hands on, because at the end of the day, I think it all comes out to like, my whole face is £25. That's what I have to say, £25. It's the same amount as one Too Faced concealer. So yeah, go ahead out there and test out some more products. And yeah, thank you guys so much for watching today's video. I love you guys and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye guys.